Hi everybody, how's it going? In the previous recipes of this data manipulation tutorial series in R, we have seen how we can use the select and filter verbs for subsetting the data using columns and rows of the dataset. In this video, we'll learn about third verb, which is mutate. Basically, mutate is used to create a new variable while preserving the existing one in the dataset. Although it can overwrite an existing column if the name of the variables is same. I'll help you understand about mutate verb using examples in this video. But first, why do we need a verb like mutate? Well, many a times during our data manipulations in our projects, we need to create either a new variable or multiple new variables that are resultant of some other operations that we perform on our data. For example, creating a column that contains the mean of observations from other columns and so forth. So without much ado, let's first load the tidyverse package in R using RStudio IDE. Here on the script editor, I already have provided two lines of codes, one for loading the package and the other for downloading the data that we have been using so far in other recipes and create the table employees_data. So let's execute these codes so that our environment is ready for the other steps. Okay, so now we have the data in table and we are ready to learn about mutate verb through examples. Let's quickly have a look at the data. As we notice, there are five income columns, the income in year 2015 through 2019 for each of the individuals in the dataset. Also, please note that there is no column which has the average incomes for those individuals. So suppose we want to create a column that should have the average of the incomes in all the 5 years for each individual, we can use mutate verb for this type of variable column creation as follows on the screen. Although the way I have written the code for computing the average of incomes for each individual into a new variable column, it cannot be deemed as an efficiently written code, and surely there are much better ways that we can choose to write the simplified code for efficient computing, but I am still opting the usual way to do so. This is just to make you understand what are we doing here to add a new column in the existing dataset or table using mutate verb. Now let's understand this code. Basically, we have added all the 5 incomes in respective years for each individual and then divided the sum by 5 to arrive on the average incomes into a new column named AVG income, short for average income, using mutate verb. And finally, we have updated the existing table using assignment operator. Let's view the table and scroll to right of it. So we can see that the expected column is added in the table filled with average incomes. Like I said before, this isn't a good example, at least in terms of efficient coding. Let me show you one of the many other efficient ways of doing such data manipulations. Here in the following code, I'm going to compute row-wise average of incomes, and instead of writing each variable name, I'll rather use C_across function from dplyr and pass only the index numbers of the columns. So when we look at the columns in the table, by hover over each variable name, a little pop-up box shows that the column number 9, 10, all the way up to 13 for the income variables. And these numbers are what we need as column index numbers. So now I pass 9 through 13 within concatenate function within C_across function. This means I'm asking the chunk of code to compute across the given column indexes, and what to compute is nothing but the mean or the average of the numbers. The result will be stored in the object AVG income 2 as shown on the screen. And then using mutate, we add this object back into the table as a variable or the column. And finally, the same is updated within the table using assignment operator. So when we execute this code and again scroll through the table to the right hand side, we can observe that a new variable is created. Please note that the result in AVG income and AVG income 2 are identical. So this is one proof that if we master tidyverse and dplyr, we can not only go on writing efficient codes using various verbs and functions within these packages, but also we can make the computations lean and fast. Nonetheless, I hope you got the idea about the verb mutate and its uses in data manipulations within data science projects. But before we come to end of the video, I want to take up one simple example in which we will override the variable name using mutate verb. Let's create a histogram for AVG income variable that we computed earlier. We can do that using native function hist and passing the variable name to it as shown on the screen. Clearly, we can observe that the data is very much skewed positively. So we need to make this data as normal, and one of the ways of doing so is that we can take natural log of it, which we can do as follows. So in this code, we applied natural log on the variable AVG income, and using mutate, we are going to override the same variable with the natural log normal values. Let's execute this code and open the table. As we expected, we can see that the changes to the data has been applied. So now, if we plot the histogram again on this variable, we can see that the data looks much normal as compared to the earlier case. Alright, congratulations! You have learned the basics of using mutate verb in data manipulations using dplyr and tidyverse in R. In the next video, we'll learn about the fourth verb, arrange, and its uses in advanced data manipulation in R. If you have any questions or suggestions, please write in comment section below and I will try to answer these as soon as possible. Also, please like this video and share with your friends if you think it could help them in learning too. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel if you have not done it so far. This would surely help me a lot and will keep me motivated. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you and happy learning.